makes me forget, makes me forget. So
you can dance or you can cry, still the sun will shine on you. You can ask for alibis.
Hello?
But they fail you every
Who is it?
They do.
It's me. Oh, you can see me. Hello, good day. Facial hair looks great. Thanks, everybody. You noticed. Oh, it's so nice of you guys. I didn't think you guys noticed. No one else does. It's just all in the chat comes up amazing. It's perfect. Awesome. Thanks for being here, everybody. Is the music good volume? How's the music? Good? I know I got facial hair now. Trying to grow it out. What's up, Jessica? Nice. Mexico, hello. Swiss. Sweden. Stop doing homework for this. Perfect. No need to do it for the rest of the night. Lithuania. Sorry. California, Netherlands. Oh, hello. Oh, you guys like my videos. Oh, my God. That's so nice. Did you put the enhanced filter on your thumbnails? Are you talking about this thumbnail? Because I just did that. I just put some filter on it. I know I'm fake. Costa Rica, England. Wow. A lot of people from out of the country. Flex your biceps, sure.
Oh.
You're welcome. I love your videos, they make my day when you post. Oh, thank you. Look, guys, I'm honestly kind of getting embarrassed about my body a little bit. You know, it's kind of like a little bit too much belly, not enough pecs. Bonnie's got the opposite problem. It's kind of like, that's the thing with me and Bonnie, you know, it's always the opposite problem. Like, he's super, wakes up early, gets work done. I'm super, like, wake up late, don't get work done. You feel me? Have you got any tips for COVID stunts I want to improve but don't know how? Oh, BoxDude22. Let's skip that question and go to the donation. Thank you so much for the super chat. $10 donation. Let's go back to the question. Have you got any tips for COVID stunts? Let's see. Tips for COVID stunting. Basically, the thing that I feel like made me progress pretty fast was being very nitpicky and noticing the little details that people do whenever they stunt. So I like to watch a lot of people, see what they do, and try to copy that. That's basically my tip. Obviously, always film your videos, your stunts, so you can, you know, watch it and look back at it. It's the little things that count. Beard giving dad vibes, you're very strong, no thanks. Have you ever had a flyer fart accidentally during a stunt? I'm sure I have. There's been plenty of times. It probably happened more when I was on like a college team, but not recently. Were you making the best of 2023 videos? It's still coming. Everything's kind of put on hold because of me, because, you know, I'm the bottleneck to the channel, like I've said many times. But yeah, it's gonna be difficult to get that video out if I still have to make the weekly videos. Even though they weren't weekly, and you guys all know that. So, put out a video yesterday. Hopefully you guys liked it. Thank you. But yeah, I think I'll do a little Q&A here for you guys. And I will answer some questions because someone told me to do a Q&A. And I wanted to make a video out of it as well and post it on my second channel, which you guys should check out. I posted one deleted scenes on there, which I could make a deleted scenes from every single vlog I've done. Which is exciting to know that I could make that, but obviously I need people to help me make it. Recently I've had people making my main videos, the ones I post, you guys know. I had two people helping me make those, trying to delegate, you know, the tasks. But it was difficult. It's difficult to edit them. I mean, that's just reality of it, because people, it's hard to for everyone to grasp my style and match it. So I think I'm just gonna have them maybe work on the blooper videos, and then I'll work on the main channel videos on my own. So it's me kind of going back to the where I started. You guys got a lot of questions. I don't know where to start. I feel like I skipped so many. What do I eat in a day? What does Dan eat in a day? Actually, I literally only eat Factor meals. And then I'll go to get fast food if I want to get fast food. But Chick-fil-A, you know, Culver's. I haven't gotten Culver's in a long time. But it was usually Chick-fil-A if I want to, you know, for Panda Express. Been doing a lot of Panda recently. But yeah, I actually try to order all of my meals with Factor, because I didn't like wasting time making the food. So I was like, I want to, you know, have some time to do things on my own. But honestly, there's a certain bliss that comes from making food, so I'm missing that. But yeah, I'm getting all my meals sent to me, and because I'm a rich little piece of shit. Nah, I'm just kidding, I'm not that rich, but it is a little expensive to do that. Jessica, how have you been? It's been a while. I've been great. It's been difficult to keep up with the videos, but like I already have one video done, but I didn't post it because I couldn't get a good thumbnail for it. And with Delaney leaving, you know, we have another flyer that we used, and it was great, but she was gone for a week, and then Delaney was also gone, but we got Delaney back for another video. She visited, and so yeah, we have the next video that I'm post on YouTube is with Delaney, so that's cool. But yeah, it won't be as much in the future, unfortunately. And Luis, thank you so much for the 5. You are 6 feet tall and funny and muscular. How do you not have a girlfriend, and what hope do we have? I don't have a girlfriend. I actually talked to a female yesterday, so it's been a while. I've been single for 5 years, so it's been a long time. But growing on working on myself and all that stuff. Are you going to invite Kat for a video? I would love to. But she's busy in Utah, so don't think it would quite be the easiest thing to do. She's busy. Abe says, updates on the Ford method and failures or successes. Did you use the Ford method? Yeah, I did, actually. We talked a lot. We were talking about all different things. You know, so yeah, we definitely got through that Ford method strategy. Delaney's going to USF. She's going to college there. You are very strong. Did you develop that strength training, or is it innate ability that you have taken advantage of? No, I don't. I wouldn't say that I was strong from the beginning. I think my strength comes from my technique, and I got that technique when I was in powerlifting in high school. Did you ever get in touch with Acro Evo? Yeah, I mean, we talked a little bit, but not much anymore. Basically, I'm just watching his videos to get ideas for an Acro video, because the Acro videos do good on the channel. I know the podcast editing is horrid because of the constant POV jumps, but actually wouldn't mind watching just the wide shot with both you and Bondi if it's easier to upload more episodes. Yeah, that's correct. It is way easier to upload more episodes, but I feel like it's not nearly as entertaining if it's just one camera angle. So I personally don't want to do that. And yeah, I'll tell you guys why. So first of all, like, obviously I am the bottleneck to the channel, and it's difficult for me to approve everything because I want everything to be good. And with the podcast, I'm going to be taking a little bit of a break from it for two reasons. The first reason is it's difficult to edit that alongside everything else I want to do, or need to do, because I want to keep the channel going. And the second reason is that I don't want to share as much personal stuff about my life, because I felt like that's what it was going into, and I was like fine with it at first, but then I realized how much stuff I'm saying, and I'm like, okay, maybe I don't want to share too much personal stuff. So then I'm just like, maybe I'll take a step back. Of course, we can change the topic, right? You guys are being so nice. I could change the topic and talk about something other than, you know, personal stuff, but I'd have to come up with that. So I gotta figure that out. How much, you know, it's like, I'm just having difficulty keeping up with the main videos. You know, it's like, that usually takes the most amount of time because I put the most effort into them. And it's just like, the biggest thing for me is coming up with that thumbnail, because we usually do something random in the video. So I gotta try to get the most viral thumbnail. And most of the time it doesn't work. So YouTube is my full-time job, and I also have a part-time job at Hybrid helping out with the schedule. Yo, dude, me and my little cousin always watching your videos, and she wants to stand on my hands. Haha, great. That's awesome, man. I don't even cheer because we don't have it here in Holland, but love your videos. Thank you very much. You guys like the beard, huh? Amazing. How'd I get the scar on my chin? I'm surprised you noticed that. That was from football. Just got tackled, and the guy was... he did like an uppercut with his helmet, and then it just like moved my mask up, and then he moved my chin guard up as well, and then it just slammed against my chin. Thank you for existing, ZA says. What an interesting thing to say. Thanks. What happened to Eliza? She's at college. Same thing with Delaney. Trying to find a flyer that is not going to be going to college, you know what I mean? So, actually, I don't know if I can... This is not, you know, fully in the books yet, but I don't know if you guys know Kaylee Odell. She is a flyer that was at Weber State, and she posts a lot of videos on YouTube, shorts and stuff. But she was a flyer that was in my videos a long time ago when I was at UCA again. So, yeah, no, you guys know Kaylee, right? Somebody knows her. Come on, guys. Yes. Kaylee's amazing. So I'm talking to her right now about being our full-time flyer. So I'm doing my dandest to get a full-time flyer that is not going to be going to college, because she's done with college now. Hopefully she's funny. Do you compete? No. I stunned with her at Weber tryouts. I was sick, dude. And all those nights I walked you home. Bonnie can be the flyer for the next episode for sure. Do you miss UCF? No, I do not. Sorry. I don't know why you don't have millions of subs. Oh, that's very nice of you. I don't know either. Okay, because I feel like my videos are better than some of the other YouTubers that I watch who have a lot of subscribers. I feel like, honestly, they put more effort into the thumbnail than they do the actual video itself, where I'm kind of like reverse. Stupid. How do you work on yourself? Are you self-reflecting, reading books? I mean, I work on myself by thinking, self-reflecting for sure. I don't really do many other things to work on myself. I just do things to relax and help my mental sanity. So I like watch anime, you know, listen to music, chill out, hang with friends. Those are the things that help me mentally for sure. Physically wise, I gotta get back into running. I can't really work out because my neck comes out of nowhere and then it just screws me. Jeffrey!
Hi.
How you doing? It's a little live stream. You want to say hi?
Hey. Where is it recording from? Oh, the camera.
Yeah.
Oh, this is nice. What's up? It's nice. What are you doing? You're editing?
No, I'm just doing a Q&A.
Oh, okay. Cool.
They can't see you. You sit on the side.
Can't see. Okay.
Hey, guys.
Michelle B. Jeff, let's go! Turn me up!
I'm in the office, so. There's probably gonna be people walking in and out. Jeff is my film, if you didn't know. Do you have a TikTok? Because I don't know which one is the real one. I do have a TikTok. It is the one with 500,000 subscribers. That's been 500,000 subscribers for about 2 years now. What anime would you recommend? Of course, I'll answer that question. Not that one. Anime I'll recommend. Castlevania is pretty sick. Death Note is always good. Attack on Titan, Tokyo Ghoul. Sword Art Online, amazing. Jujutsu Kaisen, amazing. Arcane, good. Love is War, if you want a romance. Violet Evergarden, if you want another romance. Darling in the Franxx, love that one. I watch a lot. Yeah, Solo Leveling is out now. So, Jeff has a good voice in that bathroom TikTok video. Abe,
thanks, Abe. Good voice. What TikTok is that? Wait, did you post a TikTok of me singing?
No.
Oh.
Did someone post you on TikTok?
I don't know, maybe.
Did you post a video of you on TikTok?
I don't post on TikTok.
Oh, okay. Someone's maybe was like vibing over you.
Thanks, Abe.
Is this music depressing? Someone said that. Yeah, let me fix the music. I'm not depressed. So I can't. Wait, this song's vibing. Alright, what other music can I listen to? Should I listen to some hype shit? I mean, what else would I listen to other than depressing music? Oh, you're right. I should just listen to myself. Holy shit. I didn't even think of that. Honestly, I want to listen to Hazel Eyes. No, I shouldn't listen to sad stuff, bro. I want to listen to this. God, I love this song so much. This is my next favorite song, Rum and Tequila by John Kay. It's my next favorite. Alright, so, what other questions do we have? Dan, stay who you are, believe in yourself. Believe me, for some of us, you're an absolute motivation. Thank you, man. Makes me realize that since you've been gone, my life sucks a little when your oil shines away. Who's the best bass right now in your opinion? Colin Cockrell probably. He just did a shotgun with one arm, which is absolutely wild. You have to look at his page on Instagram if you want to see it. I plan on stunting in the videos for the next 10 years. You feel me? And then I'll do like more YouTube stuff that isn't physical for probably till I'm like 45. I want to do it for a long time. I guess you should probably see the actual song that's here. Maybe if I do this. Look at that. That was fast. Damn, good job. So that's the song that's playing right now. Maybe I can have like a little thing that's moving. Is there anything that's moving? Whatever. Alright, so who's this Jess chick in the last video? She's ripped on you. I like that. Yeah, no, she's funny. She's she goes to WKU, of course. And we have a... not much to say. I mean, she's funny. She's got her personality. You know, she's very sarcastic, that's for sure. Do I plan on going on vacation this year? What country do you want to travel to? I would love to travel to Japan. But I don't think I'm going to be taking a vacation. Whenever Delaney comes up, we're going to be filming videos with her. Good to have a video outside again with some people. Good variety. Yeah, I agree. I definitely agree. Even though it kind of sucked. I don't like filming in public. I don't like filming with other people. It gets very chaotic, and I don't like that. It's a lot harder to edit, and it's a lot less funny, in my opinion. So, you going to Japan in November? What the hell? What would I rate my level of stunning? That's a good question. Out of 100, 1 out of 100, and 100 being like the top of the top, I would rate my level of stunting. My first thought was 87. But there's a lot of stuff that I can't do, so maybe I'll put myself down to like 85. Dan, I love how real your videos are. You show the ups and downs, and it helps to build my cheer mindset. Awesome. Yeah, man. We can't always show the good, you know. And plus, the bad is always probably more entertaining, usually. So, I felt like with Delaney, she made your jokes funnier. Oh, okay. You know, Delaney's great. Love your videos. Keep it up. Thank you. I will do my best. Do I weight train much? No, it's because it injures my neck if I go too hard, which kind of sucks. I only spend like, someone said, how many hours a week do you spend stunting? I'm currently only spend 2 hours, but like just for the video. But if I used to obviously spend a lot of time stunting because I was working here and doing privates, and that's what eventually led me to overuse my neck and cause that to be a problem. So I took a big step back, and now I'm only doing it for the video, recovering for the week, and then doing it again. So yeah, I think that... Crap, I forgot what I was going to say. But maybe when Kaylee gets here, you know, I feel like I would want to stunt with her more often, so I might do more. Plus, she wants to film content, too. Do you think not weight training holds you back from certain things? No. No, I feel like I got the base strength level that I could do any skill I wanted, unless it's, like, absolutely insane. If I worked at it, so all you need is the base skill level. I don't need your money, I don't need a thing. Got you on my right side, driving through a lake. Right now I'm just trying to lose weight. I wanna shave off some fat. That's personally my goal. I don't need to get bigger at all. I don't need to get my chest bigger. I just have to, if I melt away my belly, then my chest looks bigger. You know what I mean? So perfect. I'm from Wisconsin. I love your videos. Thank you so much. How did you meet Bondi, Jeff, and Eliza and Delaney? I met Bondi. Nick Prack put me in touch with him. We did a clinic together. That's how I met him. Jeff, I met on Instagram. I was looking for filmers, and then he replied. Eliza, I met at one of Bondi's clinics. And Delaney, I met when she came and did a private at Hybrid. We have another podcast filmed, so I'll be posting that one, and that might be the last one. There was another one that we filmed that was like over the edge for me when it came to me sharing too much personal stuff, so I'm probably not going to post that. Or maybe I'll just cut around it and post it. So I got two potentially episodes that are coming out in a while, and then that'll be it for a bit. So I know it sucks, but... Hold up, Minnesota gang here. Hope you're not a Packers fan. Uh-oh. Why would I not support my home team? Team was doing great. My cat, amazing. What video did you make that made you laugh the most? Love your videos. Honestly, I really like the recent video. I enjoyed it after I made it. I enjoyed it a lot, so... But it's not doing well, right? You know, it's like the video you love the most is the worst performing one, so it sucks. But yeah, it's doing like 10,000 views less than normal, less than the worst video I've ever posted, you know? So it's 10 out of 10, baby. Sucks. Especially when I wasted this entire month, didn't post anything, and then I post a flop. It's like horrible. So honestly, I'm just trying to stay afloat money wise because my expenses are like super high now because I hire a few people and so I have to make a lot to make that happen. So yeah, it definitely gets a little stressful, but I'll be able to make it. I just gotta work hard for this next month. Hopefully I can get blooper videos going, you know, gonna help with some numbers. Numbers will come. Yeah, hopefully. I just gotta come up with it. The thing about YouTube is that you could work really hard or you could come up with good ideas. You know, and it's like, come up with good ideas. You have to kind of definitely have to set aside time to think. But you need to really put yourself in the viewer's perspective and make big decisions on what to do, because if the idea is not good and all the work you're doing is pointless, it's tough. I love all your videos. Thank you, Sharia. Alexa, loved your recent video. Keep it up. Thank you. Alexa, zip it. YouTube does not need consistency to get views. You can post whenever you want. Literally doesn't matter. If it's a good video, it's going to perform good. Especially if it's a consistently type of video, right? So a lot of people like Delaney, the videos. What's up? Give me one sec.
Talk to me. I need to hear you. Me like used to shut my door when my mother screamed in the kitchen. I turned the music up, get high and try not to listen to every little fight, 'cause neither one was right. I swore I'd never be like them, but I was just a kid back then. The older I get, the more.
No, he's just stressed. Is he quitting? No. You think I'm gonna quit the best job of my life? Ain't no way in hell. This is the best job I could ever ask for. And the fact that it is the best job I could ever ask for, it makes me super pissed off when I get, you know, demotivated because of how amazing a job like this is. You know what I mean? Nick Jansen. He says, he's in the last video. Dan, tell me why you just followed me on Instagram. So, hey, bro, I understand what you're saying. I don't go on Instagram much. And I was putting your name in the description of the videos because you were in the video. So I was, I saw your Instagram and I realized I didn't follow you, so I followed you. Hey, man, it's better for me to follow you now than to not have followed you and then you would never have known that I didn't follow you. You know what I mean? But now I know sometimes it's better to let someone go. It just hadn't hit me. David Vatu, thank you for the $3. I really appreciate that. And then Big Dog Bison, $5. Thank you so much. Dan the man, loved your videos and you saved my life for real. I was in a bad place a long time ago. And I wanted to thank you personally for saving my life. I love you. I didn't. But hey, I didn't save your life. You saved your life. You know? Keep it up, man. But I'll be here. I'll be here. Always on YouTube. Come on, man. I want to show this. Right there. Yay. Are you going to be more active on Instagram? Nope. Sorry. Screw that. Mara knows my age. Yes, I am 24, almost 25. Well, I'm going to be 25 in August, so. Got a couple months, yeah. Do you remember when I got you to say Aurora in your last live? No, I don't. Sorry, Lily. I feel like if you make longer videos, you would get more views, potentially. It's just very difficult to make a long video, and it's very stressful, you know, if it doesn't do well. When's the OnlyFans coming out with you and Bondi? Pretty soon. Hey, I got the 2024 best of 2024 video, you know, started along the way. So I'm being organized with that finally. So each video, I'm plugging in the best moments of that video into the 2024 timeline. So I have it going right now. It's already a half hour. It's already a half hour long. So I gotta shorten them up a little bit or something. I'm glad you like the podcast, Danny. Yeah, we're going to be... There's like two episodes that are going to be coming out in the future. Just, it might take a little bit of time. Yeah, Best of 24 is just all my videos back to back. Oh, I see what you're saying. I appreciate it. You're saying that they're all good.
Thank you.
Yeah, that song's great, isn't it? Hey, did it ever happen to you that you really want to talk to somebody and don't know what to say? Yes, obviously, as it happens all the time. The girl that I recently just talked to, I wouldn't have talked to if Jeff didn't start the conversation. So, and now we're hanging out. So it's like, and that never would have happened if Jeff didn't start that conversation. So the fact that something like that came out of it gives me more confidence to start conversations more often. Yeah, I know. I look a lot older than I am. I watch a video and I act a lot older than I am. I watch a video every day before I sleep. Oh, that's awesome. Thank you. What's your favorite song? My favorite song is Juice WRLD, Lucid Dreams, a lo-fi remix by Natomi. I'll play this next for you. It's super sad. How long did Bounty take to finally tell you what New England actually was? Funny story about that. In the podcast, I didn't know what New England was because I thought it was... Wait, what is it? Oh, yeah. I know what it is. It's a combination of all those, you know, northeast states in Wisconsin. I mean, in the states, in the United States. So, I didn't know what that was. And then, as I was editing the podcast, I was... At that part, I was like, wait a minute. I thought he's talking about England. In the UK, right? And so I was putting in references to England, and then all of a sudden somebody came in and was just like, wait, do you not know what New England is? And then they told me, then I looked it up and I was just like, oh my god, I still didn't get it right. Now I literally didn't know until the time I was editing. When am I posting my next short? I'll post one today. I'm going to try to get the numbers back up so I'm posting every day again. Love from England, yeah. The beer looks great. Thank you, Reyna. What time is it in the U.S. now, guys? For me in Florida, it's 5:13 p.m. You should have got Bondi to join the live. That would be hilarious. He's out there working, so he's here. Is living with Bonnie similar to what he's like on videos? Funny, chaotic, or is he more chill at home? Bonnie, he's like, he can turn a switch, you know? He's like, one minute he's just like he is on videos, and then the second minute he's very business-oriented, you know, calm and focused, you know? So that's what I'll describe him as. How long have you been stunting? High school? Yes, I've been stunting since high school.
That shit does take time.
You don't really get in some situations, views from TikTok on YouTube. Like, if you want to grow an audience, you have to grow it on the platform you want to like actually be on. Because it doesn't matter how big your audience is, people don't like to transfer platforms. You might have, but most people don't. What's the worst injury a flyer has gotten stunting with you? Probably just a concussion. Wait, no, I never gave her a concussion. That was me catching a girl, and then she probably got a concussion because I kneed her in the head on accident. But the other time was this girl broke her wrist, and I wasn't stunting, but I was watching from a distance. I wasn't close enough to catch. And then yeah, she fell down, put her hand down, and broke her wrist. So it was pretty gross. Where do I see myself in 5 years? I see myself rich as fuck, in a nice house, still making my videos, having a better team that really know what needs to happen. But I still want to keep it small, I feel like. I still want to keep, you know, it effective. Yeah, no, we don't have too many bad fails. I mean, we don't have too many bad injuries. We have bad fails, but we always kind of like break the fall. What's the favorite skill you've ever tried? My favorite skill is probably... I mean, I really like double ups, of course. Yeah, I don't really know what my favorite skill is. Full rounds. I want to thank you. Kyle says, I want to thank you for the videos you post. It's helped me get through a really hard time in my life. It's helping me so much. Thank you, mate. You're amazing. Absolutely, Kyle. I'll do anything for you. I'll keep making videos for you. Are you getting rid of Bondi? What makes you think that? You are rich. You're the best team. Let's stay positive. Gotta be realistic. Yeah, I try to post my videos every Sunday. So 3 videos a week on YouTube, and then the last week gets posted on Patreon. So, yeah, you can subscribe to Patreon in any country. Patreon's where I post, like, the extra vlog to build up a consistent form of income. That's why I started it back in the day. And it's certainly helping when the YouTube channel doesn't do as well. So that's for sure. So, I mean, I really, really appreciate people who subscribe to Patreon. Maria, sorry, I can't mention anything right there about that. You should do a live podcast tour. I'd love to come watch you guys talk about random stuff. We're going to be doing a live tour of our stunting vlog, public, like a live stunting vlog. That's my dream, to do a live tour of that sort. But I'm only going to do that when I get like a million views a video. And it's like, no question, a million views a video. Doesn't matter. Doesn't matter what the thumbnail is. You know, it's like consistently that type of audience. So I'll do it at that point. But anything other than that. Yes, Indy, you can subscribe from the Netherlands. Would you go to DC? Yeah, of course. I'll try to go as many places as I can. How tall are you? I'm 6'2". How is the search for an editor going? I'm still working on it. Still working on it. Have some good, I mean, I have editors that are, they're good at what they do, but they're still lacking the concept of what is good and what is bad, you know. So it's like finding somebody with the knowledge of being able to cut something or keep something, and the vision of what the video could be, is what I need to find. Most of my editors are technically sound, and they just need to get that experience. Since you expelled, it's been some dark nights, Christian Bale. All right, bro. I'm in love, or maybe not. Who cares? Fall in love, or maybe not. Was there? Need someone to keep you there. I know. Maybe I'm just not the one for you. I'm in love, or maybe not. Who cares? Fall in love, or maybe not. Was there? Need someone. Oh, Jessica, do you have recommendations for songs for stunt montage? I have a song come up on my Spotify that I think would be a good one. Yeah, let me know what it is. I'm excited. I'll type it in right now. It better be good though. You got a link to your playlist, Big Chief? What kind of playlist? I have all my playlists linked in my playlist tab on my channel. I got it all there for you, baby. When you were at UCF in your last video, I thought we might see Eliza, but she must not have been around. No, we were never at UCF in the last video. We were in Orlando, you're right, in the same like location, but Eliza was competing, so you can't really stunt for fun when she has to compete. You've got us in some really good music. I got you, baby. This is my nice happy beats playlist. Just make Dust Dan an editor. He'll know exactly what to do. Thank you, Habibi. The sun still shines while I'm taking those. Last night I lost my car in K-Town. My phone died, I barely found my way out. Someone said something about a cat. I have a brown short hair tabby cat, so it's a very classic cat. You think I have a cult following? Maybe one day. I want a cult following of 100,000 subscribers at least. That's like my dream. But then I want to get a million. So you need to get there. Brazil is watching you. Thank you so much for the vibe. Teacher Chris Brazil. You put it in the chat. Stutter Riot. Shaboozy. I'll look it up. Stutter Riot. I'm surviving, chasing the horizon. No, I never get there. Oh, I feel like I've seen this. I've been stuck out on a night. Bang. Who in here trying to start a fire? Yeah. Who in here trying to start a fire? Yeah, it's a good song. It just very, I've heard it a million times, so I wouldn't really want to use it probably. But it is copyright. I wish I could use it. I wish I could use, you know, the songs that are actually good. But unfortunately, I only have to use songs that are copyright free. And the YouTubers who use copyright music don't make any money from the video that they make. So I think it's insane that they don't use it, but I have to if I want to survive. So YouTube is like, YouTube revenue is like 50% if I don't have a sponsorship, unless it's 25% if I do have a sponsorship. In a stunt community, is there consistent innovations and new moves each year that pushes the community to do crazier and crazier stunts? Yeah, there is. Every year, the stunts get crazier and worse technique.
Awesome.
Would you do a best of 2024 video so far? That's hilarious. Nothing ever comes without a consequence of cost. Tell me, what time is it? It is 5 o'clock. Whatever step in, will it save us from a sin, will it? Cause this house of mine stands strong. That's the price you pay. What has been the best part of starting your channel? Best part about starting my channel is basically knowing that my audience remembers previous videos and they reference it in the recent one. That's my favorite part. I've always wanted to have that. I've always wanted to have lore, and I've always wanted to have things that, like, if they see a photo of me, they can kind of predict how I'm feeling in that moment because they know me. You know, that's like what I've always loved. That's what I've always wanted. Do you have any questions for your fans that we can answer in the chat? Oh, okay, that's probably a good question. Let's see, any questions for you guys that I would like to see an answer to? It's probably a good idea to get some live thoughts. Do you guys like seeing acro more, or do you like seeing stunting more? I like both stunting for me. I like stunting more, stunting, I guess. Stunting, mix of both. I like them both. Acro, personally, stunting, what's the difference? I like you. Stunting. You often find yourself on your knees and, oh my god, that's glitched. Mods, ban that guy. Just kidding, you're fine. I don't have any mods. Don't care what stunts you do, watching for the people. Yeah, I've always done sports. Watching for Bond, to be honest. Acro is good to mix it up, though. Great content regardless. Acro meaning crazy or stunting? No, it's just kind of like, I don't know what it is. It's just like different. Honestly, both. Whatever you do, I watch for you and whoever else is in the video. Man, forgot all of that. I like that Veronica girl. Yeah, I'm trying to get her up as well. We're trying to get other people in. Like, hopefully we can get Kaylee Odell in the videos. But that'll be in the summer. So at that point, she might be the full-time flyer, and it's going to be huge. But for now, we are going to be stunting with what we have, and what we have is great still. So. No, I haven't had any serious injuries other than my neck. That's probably a pretty serious one, actually. What's your 10-year plan? Making videos. 10 years more is probably going to be when I stop stunting. And I'll try to do other content other than stunting. If you're trying to avoid the dad allegations, the goatee won't help you. What is the place you went to in the last video? I know you guys have shot videos there tons of times. Yeah, it's called the UCA, what's called ESPN Worldwide Sports Football Field, the sports location, and that's where all the teams practice. So everyone like goes there for cheerleaders. What is the place you went? Oh, sorry. Would you get a tattoo? No. I kind of want to, but not really. How much, in your opinion, does a bass need to lift for a comfortable extension QB? I would say if you can overhead, strict press, no legs, 135 a couple times, you're good. What is the favorite video you made? The recent one I like. Wait, do you mean Kaylee Odell? She's sick as fuck. I know, guys. Do you think shave, please? That's the first comment someone said about shave.
Yeah. Yeah.
I don't know. So, yeah. Kaylee Odell. I know you guys know she's sick. You know, she's really good and all that stuff. And I know that too, guys. I'm just like you, you know? It's like I got the same attitude when it comes to watching videos, and I watch YouTube all the time. It's like I feel like I'm on the wavelength. And I know Kaylee would be huge. So I'm trying my hardest, baby. DNA not for imitation, but DNA an abomination. This way you win the matrix. Yeah, it's like the same timing of the McDonald's video. My recent at UCA, so it's like the same. Well, that was high school national, so a little different, but same place. The next podcast will probably come out next month. Next podcast episode. Can I explain the difference between acro and stunting? They just have, so acro is more of like holding movements for a longer period of time with perfect technique, lining up everything, lining up the lines that you have in the move, and then cheer stunting is more of like throwing it and catching it, you know? Like acro doesn't do as much as throwing and catching unless you get really good. But, yeah, cheer is a lot more throw and catch. Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah.
Oh, yeah. Dear God, where'd you go? You haven't been answering your phone. Not saying I'm mad, but the world is fucked up. So you should
thank you. Thank you, Anaya. My role models for YouTube, that's a good question, is Danny Duncan, David Dobrik, back when he was, yeah, actually not canceled. Mr. Beast, Colin and Samir,
beefing with science. And by the way, I got some bad pressure in my sinus. It may be a migraine.
PewDiePie.
Climate change, but who am I to talk? I haven't recycled in 5 days.
Dear God, dream.
I still celebrate Christmas, because the novelty of holidays is really big business. You heard the prophecy of old Saint Nick. I heard this year he got Miss Claus some big fake tits. And the longer you go missing, the more the story's twisted. And people count the days to make their birthday wishes. And it's never gonna, never gonna change. So you should come around more. Oh, dear God, where'd you go? You haven't been answering your phone. Not saying I'm mad, but the world is fucked up. So you should come around more. Oh, dear God, I hate to say people don't believe in you these days. Not saying I don't, but the world is fucked up. So you should come around more. Goddamn. People say that I'm insensitive and that I usually...
Yeah, no, it's my dream to be on Colin and Samir's podcast. You know, because someone said you should do an interview with them. That's my dream. For sure. For sure. That'd be sick. Yeah, I mean, I gotta be that famous, though. And to actually have them want me to be on there. Because the only people they interview are just, like, you know, wildly popular. So, yeah, no, I definitely gonna... That's one of my dreams. But, yeah, I think I'm going to be done. Oh, I'm going to give to the membership. Thank you so much, Marta. Yeah, I think the next step for the podcast would be to have guests on it so I don't have to talk about so much about myself. So that'll probably be the next step. But it'll be a while before I do that. So I appreciate you guys being here very much. And I'm going to be done now, though. Just wanted to stream for a little bit, answer some questions, and then I'm going to leave. It's getting dark now. I want to go for a run and try to restart my life. Restart my life in a good way. So yeah, hopefully you guys enjoyed it, and I will see you guys in the next one. Bye. No, I'm just kidding. All right, see you guys.